So this is a typical approach between a single and multi-tenant scenarios, right? So like we saw the earlier case, the traditional model. So you see here the first two boxes, one and two, the top ones, they fall under the category of what we call as the single tenant. And the three and four falls under the category of multi-tenant. So in case of one, it's pretty much what we saw. So when you get a customer or a tenant, you take a particular copy of the software, you create an instance for that customer, do whatever changes you want to, and just deploy it for that customer. So you see in what, number one, you see a red color instance, a blue and then yellow. So what it means is you could have different code bases or source code being deployed for each of these tenants. Level 2 is slightly a better option in terms of maintainability. At least as you could see, the versions you are having, the source code you are having, are pretty much the same. So at least you are not doing specific code changes. At least you are ensuring that the code still remains the same. Maybe you can try to keep it to an extent possible generic. And that way, through configurability, you can try to meet the customer's need. But the challenge here is the more changes the customers are going to ask, you are not going to be able to achieve it in the level 2. So you might end up in going back to level 1. Right? So with minimal changes, there are not too many customization, level 2 might work for you. But when the number of customizations are increasing, then you will have to go ahead and modify that. So these two constitute the single tenant models. In some cases, particularly in case of SaaS, people do follow this model. It has its own advantages. We'll look into that shortly. But then from a maintainability and cost perspective, and particularly over a period of time, both these models may not be effective ones. Three and four, the multi-tenant models. The fundamental difference between these two are the capability to take up more load. So here in level 3, you are having pretty much one instance kind of a model serving multiple tenants. And the number of tenants you can serve could be varying depending on the hardware configuration, depending on the capacity you have. But from a source code perspective, you are trying to maintain one instance of your source code. And in terms of level 4, it's pretty much the same, except that it could serve a large volume of tenants. You're talking about, let's say, 1,000, 2,000 tenants, or even more than that. So when you're growing by that scale, which is possible in a SaaS model, where you are trying to address small and medium customers, SMBs, so it's very much possible you can grow to that extent. And the other scenario could be consumer-facing systems, consumer portals or consumer-based applications. So where the end users, the individuals could be considered as a tenant, that's another case where the tenants' numbers could be pretty high. So in both these cases, so you have a single instance serving multiple people and the entire product being multi-tenant capable, which means it knows, detects which customer, which tenant is requesting for information, and then the whole thing works based on the settings for that particular customer. So looking at the factors between these four levels, how do these things vary and where exactly should I be concerned about? So some of the factors like operational efficiency, like we saw, it's going to be extremely low in terms of level 1. As we saw, you just cannot maintain it so many versions in the first place. So relatively speaking, level 1 has a very low score on operational efficiency compared to level 4, where the efficiency is going to be extremely high, because even if you take a small upgrade or an enhancement to be done, you are going to be doing it in either one place or in a handful of places, right? So which means it's going to be much more effective. Maintenance efforts, extremely high, level 1, because you have to keep doing it again and again. Level 4, again, is going to be very low, maintenance-wise. Scalability, again, level 1 is not scalable at all. As a model, you're going to keep spending on infrastructure. You're going to keep repeating things, so it's not going to be a nice model from a scaling perspective. Again, level 4 is more better compared to that. Time-wise, level 1 might take you less time to build or move to, primarily because you're not doing any changes over there. So you're not going to be spending time in terms of modifying anything, right? You take your functionality as it is and you are giving to the customer. But level 4 involves building a multi-tenant architecture in place, right? As I said, it does not come out of the box, but then you have to build an architecture which is multi-tenant capable, which can identify these different tenants and work accordingly. So it's going to take time to build that solution in the first place, and then move your application or product, or build your application or product on top of that. The transition cost, once again related to the time, is going to be quick and less cost compared to level 4. Level 4, again, because of the effort involved in building this multi-tenant architecture, the cost also is going to be high from an initial perspective. But again, from down the line, from a maintainability and operational efficiency, you're going to gain a lot compared to level 1. And in fact, some of the industry facts show that almost a multi-tenant application or a product, from an efficiency perspective, from a cost efficiency and operational efficiency perspective, can be 16x times better than a single-tenant system. Now, this is a very rough figure. Of course, this figure keeps changing from scenario to scenario, but from the project that have been done by some large organizations like MasterCard, the data that they have got is as much as 16x times. So that can give you an idea of the cost involved in the savings involved in a multi-tenant scenario. Engineering skill set, you don't need anything much in level 1. It's just pretty much deploying it and providing access to the tenants. Engineering skill set is definitely required to build a proper solid multi-tenant framework for level 4 kind of scenario. Now, the important point, the last point, is the customer value add. Now, in this whole discussion, we did not talk about the customer, right? Because the very fact that customers are going to be accessing this final solution, they are, one, least bothered about how you are doing this, right? Whether you are hard coding it, or you are changing it, or you are doing it with multi-tenancy, they are not going to be bothered too much. That's the first point. And the second point is, this whole thing could be abstracted. For example, when you go for a SaaS, all the customer is going to get is a URL, and then based on a website, he's going to access the product, which means the customer may not even be aware of whether the product is working in a single-tenant model, level 1, or working in a multi-tenant model, level 4. So it's totally abstracted. So the fundamental point being, the whole multi-tenancy itself could be more helpful from an operational and efficiency improvement per se for the developer, for the ISV, or for the application provider, rather than for the customer.